What up, Naughty Steppers? It's Connor Whitmore here again with another review for you on the Naughty Step channel. And today, I'm going to be talking to you about the new Mefjus album released on Vision Recordings' Manifest. Hailing from Linz in Austria, Martin Schober is recognised as one of a few artists delving into the Neurofunk style of music that many see Noisia, founders of Vision, as having popularised. An important figure in the drum and bass scene since around 2012, and someone who many hail as the heir to Noisia somewhat, with whom a lot of parallels can be drawn from the Dutch trio. With people merely being happy with the part he is playing, as someone doing things as adventurous and forward-thinking with the drum and bass genre as Noisia have been. Very much filling the extended gaps vacated by the time between album releases from Noisia. With this being his second album since 2014's Emulation, released under the Critical Music record label. Amongst a smattering of EPs and singles, across a multitude of other labels such as Shogun, Neosignal, Ram and many more. Not an artist who I've been overly keen on since I started listening to his stuff in 2015, but definitely someone whose style I wanted to see fit in an album since its development over that time. And my instinctive reaction to this album is that that format is exactly what is needed for his music, especially with it resembling an upgrade and evolution from his usual techniques. Taking what he's doing to new levels not only in the number of tracks, with this album clocking in at a gargantuan 17, but also in terms of the sheer ambition on show here, his intention was to present an updated version of himself, and he's done so with aplomb here. Bringing this newfound diversity into the album format has allowed the cinematic side of his production to ring true. Taking place in almost every track, setting a scene and providing a world view with every opening sequence. In several instances, most notably the tracks Ring Shifter and Sizzle Fizzle, we get the impression that we, as the human listener, are landing on a new planet in the hope of making contact. Only for the terror and destruction provided by the drops to rain, a constant reminder throughout that trespassing on this territory will only bring disappointment. The final example of this coming in the final track, The Sirens, where the hope of a new dawn is extinguished by the carnage of a drop, where the heaviness and intricacy of Mefjus' production come together very well. Taking several bewildering turns before a rising, fuzzy trumpet sound that very much signals the definitive loss of hope, evaporating into the distance in glorious fashion. The hope is that the transformation has taken place, as the vocal sample suggests, but to me this makes clear the struggle of man's manifestation on other planets. And this is the image that I take from the album as a whole, something that is definitely embellished by other introductions across the 17 tracks. From the mechanical, industrial approach of Fractured to the spookier, gloomier opening sequences of Muskox and Assembler, to the more percussion-led intros of Sleazebag and Uneasy, which are important for this album in bringing the emphasis back onto the structures that drive this album forward. And this goes without even mentioning the introduction to the album itself, eerie and dramatic and with a really warped sense of things going wrong, a very enticing first track. All of which, in their idiosyncratic ways, adhere to that epic, grand, cinematic appeal that permeates this album so strongly. The epicness enabled by the sounds more so than the lengths of the tracks, I would say. Taking the step to incorporate his style into this extensive format was the best thing he could do, but I feel like it's the sounds themselves that do this momentousness justice more so. Returning to Sleazebag, we have those little nicks of sound that run through the build and drop that are such a delicate but significant touch. A seriously underground track that is very guttural and barren, almost entirely void of happy feeling, but my god, it gets you right where you want it to. The manipulation of sounds at the beginning of Muskox, exhibiting a crazy likeness to the track Tentacles by Noisia in its twisted and malformed way. The drums midway through the first drop of the album, at 2 minutes 10 of Fractured, a brilliantly intricate and impactful moment of isolation before cracking back on with the heaviness. The warm sub-bass that chugs away in Divergence and also has a big say in Uneasy, providing a necessary fervent energy to the album overall. And the track Pivot, where there is just so much going on, from the guitar twangs to the gasping vocal utterances and the swampy, slimy, winding down notes. This one for me is especially complex, and that isn't to say that the other 16 aren't, in the interaction between their component parts, it's just this one more so because it seems to include more. All of these sounds and hundreds of others coming together to push their tracks and the album that bit further every time, making it truly epic in its design. Moreover, the notion of track length becomes even more redundant in light of the abundance of short-lived songs that each serve their purpose so well within Manifest. From Physically to Work It and Uneasy and Volition, all of which come in at under 3.5 minutes, which you usually wouldn't associate with the drum and bass genre. But it's here that Schober tones down his style to go into previously unthought of territories, especially in the shortest tracks, Work It and Volition. Experimenting with stretched half-time tempos and dipping into more hip-hop infused beats, a genre that inspired him hugely in his earlier days of music production. These shorter numbers are also reflective of his ability to make this album more well-rounded, moments of respite in amongst the blistering heaviness. It also helps that there are no vocalists on this album, creating that spacey, eerie vibe that makes it less personal and more guttural and intense as an auditory experience. With more focus on the instrumentals, you are plunged into a whirlwind of feelings provided by the music without any distraction from lyrics layered over the top. And the few samples that Mefjus uses on this album, in the shape of samples, are very poignant for their respective songs. The If I Could sample from the third track, being so vulnerable and innocent, a striking contrast from the jagged and disjointed drop it lays on top of. In Together, with the It Will Be You and I sample, which I find very moving amidst the following ravenous, grisly drop, as if they only stand a chance on this planet if they stick and work together. All the more comical example of Muskox, where we are instructed to stay out of the way before being greeted by a succession of mooing sounds that leave us unknowing as to whether we've escaped its charge or not. And the lament of Divergence, which talks about things not being quite how they were, still exciting but very, very different. What kind of relevance this may have for Mefjus as an artist, I'm not sure, but the comments certainly have a very formidable presence atop the feathery, percussive backdrop. There's also the vocal samples to the final track about transformation, but I have discussed those already. And the album is also not without its fair share of fantastically seizing and invigorating drops. From the slamming howitzer of Physically to the emotionally fueled Volition and the more staggered layouts of Ring Shifter, Sleazebag and Muskox. And in bringing to light the expertise on show here through the drops, the introductions, the plethora of sounds on show and so much more, you realise how complete this album is for what it is, which is fundamentally a drum and bass album. I haven't elucidated on the very minuscule drawbacks of Manifest precisely because they are that, so small that they become almost irrelevant in the context of the album. Schober takes his style of music to new heights in its exploration of different tempos and moods, frameworks and interactions between different sounds. Amazing energy to this thing throughout, at times more subtle, others more in your face, but he picks his moments of intensity so well. Resultantly, it never gets too much in terms of the largeness of the sounds, having those previously discussed moments of respite to take the album down the mellower, more pensive avenues. But in both its more reticent and extravagant ways, it retains that insane level of clarity throughout, not only in the sounds themselves, but in the transitions and the mixdowns and everything of that ilk. Therefore, he evidences how fresh the drum and bass genre can be in this 1 hour and 8 minute journey. Going far beyond what many would expect with that style of music, particularly in terms of his percussion, something I haven't gone too in-depth on but which is amazingly varied throughout. In pretty much every moment, let alone every track, everything comes together so well to create an overall sound, each so unique in what it wants to deliver, that's incredibly atmospheric and full and difficult to resist, quite frankly. Not that I have an inkling to resist this music in any way. And it is these themes and motifs that let the imagination run wild with this album, allowing us to realise potentially that it's not even an album as much as it is a film, a collection of scenes. Painting a picture effortlessly, conjuring up images of heroism and grandeur, the feeling of the unknown, things that we, as curious, technology-driven humans, can resonate with today. There's so much to this thing, I feel like I've barely scratched the surface, and I couldn't recommend it enough to anyone who has any slight interest in dark electronic music of any kind. If you're a dubstep fan, a trap fan, a bass house fan, you know, whatever it is, check this out. This is art. This is beauty. This is a stunning construction of sounds, each song with its own mood and ambition. You just have to appreciate how much is going on here. The attention to detail, everything so carefully thought out and formulated with that immense clarity throughout. Mefjus is someone who is big on small details, so they're there to be appreciated. Now go and appreciate them. Just a real musical journey, holding you in its grasp from start to finish. His aim was to display the variety that drum and bass has to offer, and he has done so brilliantly here. Almost 3 years in the making, and you can really tell how much went into this piece of work. I honestly think we'll look back on this as a sort of paradigm shift moment for the drum and bass genre. And no collaborations on this thing at all, and for that he must be lauded even more and recognised as a potential new great for bass music in general. He's currently in the process of taking his live show to the next level, blending his sound with visuals, and I really hope that comes off for him because it would be a truly stunning spectacle. One that I would love to witness myself, and knowing he plays mostly in the UK makes me very happy about that prospect. Now, in terms of a favourite from Manifest, then I think I would have to go with Sinkhole. I love how it's built over time, and that very subtle power and force to it, just a very quietly compelling track. And in terms of a recommendation, if you enjoyed this album, then I would just check out all of Noisia's stuff and particularly their albums. It's clear where Mefjus gets some of his inspiration from, and, you know, no one is complaining. And so, everyone, that is that for another review on the Nawtystep channel, this time on the new album from Mefjus, released on Division Recordings, entitled Manifest. Thank you very much, and as always, for tuning in. What were your thoughts on this album having listened to it? Which tracks were your favourites? If you're not into drum and bass usually, do you think you'll go and check it out now? Let me know in the comments below. If you did enjoy this video, then be sure to give it a big thumbs up, share it about, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, hitting the notification bell along the way so that you can be notified whenever I upload to the Nawtystep channel. Next to my head, there should be a link to some other drum and bass related videos on this channel if you enjoyed this one. And lastly, don't forget to like and follow Nawtystep across all social media if you haven't already. With everything linked, including the recommendations, in the description box down below. And as ever, if it's naughty, then you know, guys. So be sure, as always, to keep it naughty and stay safe. And I shall see you all in the next one. Peace out.